Welcome to the special talk entitled What We Have Learned from E-Learning in Korea by Professor Dr. Da Jun Hwang, Professor at Sun Kun Kwon University, Republic of Korea, and Secretary General. Please be informed for the program of the special talk as follows. After this will be the introductory remark by Assistant Professor Dr. Wilat Leut Paitun Pan, Vice President of Sipathum University. And after that will be a special talk delivered by Professor Dr. Da Jun Hwang. After that will be a question and answer session. And finally will be the gift presentation and photo session. And now it is my honor to request Assistant Professor Dr. Wilat Leut Paitun Pan, Vice President of Sipathum University, to deliver the introductory remark, please.
Professor Dr. Da Jun Hwang, the President, Executive, and Faculty Members of Sipathum University. This is a golden opportunity for Sipathum University that Professor Hwang has kindly enough to spare his very, very busy time for us before his airplane take off today, tonight. It's our honor to have you here. Thanks to Ajahn Assistant Professor Dr. Supani, Ajahn Jinda, and that team, as well as the Office of Personnel that arranged this very interesting and valuable talk from Professor Hwang. I would like to introduce Professor Hwang for just very brief, because he has very long list of professional. Professor Hwang is a real expert in e-learning and ICT education. He has outstanding and extensive experience at the international level. Currently, Professor Hwang is a professor at School of Information and Communication Engineering at San Kung Kwon University, Seoul, Korea. Also, he is the Secretary General of the Korean Council of University Education, the organization who accredit higher education in Korea, like Sokor in Thailand. Prior to that, he has consecutively been the president of the Korea Education Research and Information Service. He is also an advisor for cyber education to the Ministry of Education and Ministry of Unification of Korea government. Moreover, he has been actively involved with ICT and e-learning, not only with leading national but also international organizations. His work has been awarded the Grand Prize in ICT and Education from UNESCO and the Platinum Awards from IMS Global. He also holds an honorary doctoral degree on e-learning in Moscow, Russian Federation. This special event is being held to showcase of successful e-learning, and this is also key strategy plan for becoming real ICT campus and quality global connection of the university. So may I please invite Professor Dr. Da Jun Hwang to deliver a talk on what we have learned from e-learning in Korea. Thank you.
Actually, I'm very pleased and honored to be here because it is, I think that in terms of university
city,
that's
just the one.
They have a microphone.
Share the experiences as well as the lessons from your learning in Korea. But the contents I'm going to deliver to you is not so very much related to just e-learning, but it is also relevant to how to implement, how to realize what you have been thinking, what you will see, okay, what you're going to do in the future. This kind of relevant to your vision and the global competency of your university. That is kind of the theme as well as the addition now. But anyway, my title, just you know, what we've learned from e-learning in Korea, actually what we learned. Just in summary, just before getting into my slide, just in summary, coordination. Okay, coordination is key word. And strong leadership. Of presence, quite important, and encouraged to motivate faculty members, even administrative staff, to participate every time of your contest that you have been dreaming of. So. That is kind of, just summary, but I'm going to keep waiting. Michael. This one. Forward. He's there. Well, whatever, I jot down in the topic of my talk, I'm looking to see, take a great overview of the learning and the situations of facing Korean higher education institutions. And then I'm going to give you how to achieve innovation, especially in education institutions and education itself. And then what kind of issues of e-learning in the future? Okay. You need to pay more attention to looking. Okay. And followed by okay, this is a very brief summary of impact of e-learning as well as ICT education. Actually, the e-learning is recognized kind of the best practice that Korean government has taken to promote the learning opportunities for Korean universities. Now, e-learning adoption into education area, especially in 2009, we have 77% of average adoption. As you can see, detailed statistics of higher education institutions and primary secondary and training as well. Anyway, in higher education institutions, what you just got from e-learning? Openness. The openness and the collaboration. The university began to learn how to make a mutual collaboration among the different universities. This kind of lesson. And I think that as far as I know, and during my presence in Paris, we just initiated, our company initiated to promote the e-learning among the different universities in Korea. The national initiative was called eCampus Vision 2007. eCampus Vision 2007. The part of the project consists of, you know, how to set up regional e-learning support center. And 10 to 18 Korean universities, okay, get together to kind of formulate a team to, you know, challenge government initiative project. So through the kind of, you know, just experience, each university involved in the kind of, you know, the project, okay, they came to know the real value of the collaboration. Okay, since then, the collaboration is quite, you know, at personal level, university level, so institute level, as well as the institutional level. What about the second and primary secondary just, you know, education in terms of our school teachers are encouraged to innovate the pattern. Because, as you may know, actually adoption of e-learning into education system, okay, requires a new way to think, to do it. In the case of, you know, implementation of e-learning in a regular as well as formal education system, the teacher, okay, tends to be, not teacher, to be kind of a facilitator. That means that the new role must be just honored by the teacher. So innovation of pedagogy and equality of education, actually, e-learning in Korea really contributed to just, you know, extend learning opportunity for the students who live in rural areas. As you may know, Korea is one of the countries that has been strong as well as fierce competition to get into, you know, premium class in university. So private tutoring cost became a kind of, you know, big social issue, okay, to Korean education community as well as society. So our government has decided to challenge the problem rather than, you know, private tutoring. There was, why not promote e-learning, okay, even in just a primary and secondary education environment. So, you know, Sci-Home learning system, which has been just established May 2005, now just 4.4 million students registered Sci-Home learning system, which is nationwide e-learning system, aiming for providing primary and secondary school students the learning opportunities after classrooms. What are the lessons from the training through e-learning? It already took its positions kind of strategy for HLD, Human Resource Development, and Human Resource Management. It became really, you know, important part. As you may know, company employee just really, you know, living really happy life as in time. So what were the past impact? As far as I know from my just gathering as well as my survey on the open analysis papers published in Korea. And what I noticed is that, you know, there has been a big, you know, improvement in terms of the productivity, in terms of, you know, saving education costs, and in terms of, you know, just extending learning opportunities. So since establishing the e-learning industry promotion law in 2004, okay, e-learning just emerged. E-learning emerged kind of new type of knowledge business. In 2009, the revenue of the e-learning market from the demand side and the supply side is almost 2.7 and 2.09 billion US dollars. This very important part, without paying more attention to just establishing e-learning industry promotion role, this was done in some national leaders with clear visions putting outside of Korea. Without their sacrifice, without their enthusiasm, okay, to look at the potential of e-learning, it was almost impossible. So, anyway, thanks to the enthusiasm and the contribution, we already have new type of knowledge business, say just e-learning business. No? Okay. Where the Korean e-learning is now? At the very beginning of adoption, this adoption of the Korean peninsula, it was recognized kind of the learning methodology. Okay? And then it is got among hostels as being a catalyst for education innovation. Okay. In parallel with the government initiative to promote ICT. Okay. But and then it is further just move toward taking its position as kind of HLD strength. And then now it has strong places as kind of knowledge business. But what about the key factor? The success of e-learning in private education institutions. Clear vision and a competitive marketing strategy is very important. Why? You are trying to implement or adopt e-learning into your education system. Why? And what are the goals that you want to achieve during the e-learning? You must be ready to respond. It is one of the clear vision and a competitive marketing strategy. The second one is innovation for sustainable goals. Through the adoption of e-learning, your education system must open to outside. Opening your gate to outside. It would not be really good for the professor, because the life of professor is strongly protected, okay, by the wall of the campus, by the wall of the classrooms, by the wall of the peers. But it cannot be possible anymore. After opening gate towards the outside through the internet. But seems to be kind of satisfactory, especially to the faculty members. But never. We think of more than that. It also motivated us, as well as encouraged us, to look at what is happening, okay, outside of my classrooms, outside of our campus, outside of the island. That should be the first step, okay, to change yourself, to innovate who you are, what your university is about, why you are striving to implement your learning for your students and faculty members. And to get it, really just a powerful ticket to be a global leader in higher education area. You must look here. You must put high value on quality of personalities. That is why we need in the new year the competency of human resources, faculty members, tutors, even the ministry staffs. Without you know, the guarantee, okay, the high quality of one of them, you know, you must just prepare an idea for you. What is the training system for faculty members, administrative staffs? What about others? Performance management should be based on outcomes and evidence, not just on data. And, you know, you must care more about satisfaction of students. That's why they are saying that, you know, they are kind of in popularity saying that, oh, you must pay more attention to student-centered education, student-centered learning. Why? You must earn the satisfaction of students. Okay, the last part of the success program would be how to leverage available resources in learning technologies. This is right. Okay. And whenever you are just invited to think about the innovation of meetings, the first thing our presence you do is what is your context of innovation? Okay. What is the context of innovation? Okay, according to the context, you want to choose, you want to just refocus in there, the quality. Okay? More outcomes, more evidence, more providing accessibility to the students, okay, to make them more freedom to access information and services through the this a smart gadget like this one, and pay more attention and satisfaction. Anyway, what kind of context? That you want to achieve. Could you change my attitude? Okay, sure. That's fine. This is a slide prepared for showing how to challenge the issues of the learning higher education institutions. The first one is take a strong leadership from university authorities and initiate to challenge and change education. Second one is motivate diverse participations. Why I just say put small dinosaurs. It has, she has really long hair, long necks. But the current point is not just a cute neck, it must be long hairs. As far as I know, there are many long tails at this university. Please, to honor the value of long hair. Even though this seems to be just a kind of group that has just a negative response to university policy. But if you succeed to persuade them to take another way, you almost got it, like you must in terms of sustainable work. Without drawing much more attention, you cannot reach to the goal. Okay. And when you just talk about motivation, you must think also about how to design as well as elaborate the emerging system. I know. I just very familiar with saying that the Korean focus is saying that, oh, money is not a problem. It might be true, but not true. Money is a problem. But even to motivating your professor, we need money. We need other kind of the reason why they need to be motivated. So to approach to challenge innovation, I think that finding small people, they need to take strong leadership to lead the change, innovation, and as well as icebreaking. This is a coordination in promotion of the learning period from the government perspective. As you can see, many ministries here, Ministry of Education and Science Technology, Ministry of Labor, Ministry of Public Administration and Security, many ministries. But anyway, Ministry of Education and Science Technology has been taking care of the promotion of the learning in education center. What about the labor? Just taking care of company for training. What about the Ministry of Knowledge Economy? They are very much focused on promotion of the learning industry. What about the Ministry of Culture, Sports and Culture? They seem to be pretty much in promotion of K-pop. Anyway, just content development. Okay, content development. Okay, next one. This is a legal framework. It's really well organized. Very the center of my supply, the learning industry promotion law. Outside of this one, actually, the e-learning has been recognized as kind of the methodology of the methodology of education, methodology of training, but now it became a really important part of the knowledge business. How to achieve innovation in